Today, we're going to be discussing this thing on the left here called the toolbar, and also the different types of selection we can do in the 3D viewport in object mode. To start off, let's add a few objects. So I'm going to press Shift A, which as we know is our add menu, and under mesh, I'm going to choose cube. Then I'll press Shift A again, and under mesh, I'm going to choose cylinder, and I'll press G and X, which as you know will grab it on the X axis, so we can move it along like this. If you're not sure how to move objects in Blender, make sure to check out the previous tutorial, where I cover this more in depth. Then I'm going to cover a new command today for objects, which is called the duplicate command. To do this, all I need to do is with my object selected, so I'll left click it, I can press Shift, hold it, and then press D, and that's going to allow me to duplicate my object like this. And then I can press G and then X again, just to move it along the X axis. And there we are, now we have a few objects to play around with. So as I mentioned, we're going to be talking about the toolbar today. First of all, if your toolbar is hidden, you can press the T key on your computer, which will toggle it on or off. You'll also notice when it's hidden that there's a little arrow here which you can click to open it as well. Let's start from the top, which is this option called Select Box. This is the default in Blender, and it pretty much means when you left click and hold, a box is going to appear which will allow you to select everything inside of the box. Notice how when I bring my box over these two objects, they've both become selected. You notice one of them has a brighter highlight here, and another one has a more dim orange highlight. The brighter highlight, which may be a bright yellow or like a white like this, is the active selected object. The orange one is selective, but isn't the active selected object. This isn't really important for now, but I thought I'd let you know just to get you familiar with that information early. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a later tutorial. Another thing to note is when you have multiple selected objects, you can actually edit them at the same time. So if I was to left click this object mode option and change to edit mode, you can see both of these objects will go into edit mode. To come out of edit mode, I'll just press tab on my computer, or you can select it from up here again. If I left click and hold this select box, you can see we have a few different options. The tweak option will allow you to left click and drag to move objects like this. So I can left click and then I can left click and hold my selected object, and that's going to allow me to move it around like this. I'll left click and hold this option again, and next we have select circle. This will allow me to select things which I want using a brush motion. You'll notice though, when I brush over these, that nothing's getting selected, and that's because we need to kind of hit the center of our object with this tool. So I'm going to aim for, you see where this white dot is? That is the origin point, which is roughly the center of the object. I'm going to want to hit roughly that point on all these objects. So I'll left click and drag, and you can see if I kind of hit that center point, it's going to select them nicely. In the top left hand corner, there's a radius option. And if I increase the size of my radius, you can see I've now got a bigger brush, which will allow me to probably select things a little bit easier. Then we got Select Lasso, and what this does is I'm just going to left click anywhere else in my scene to deselect everything. And now when I left click and hold, you can see that's going to select everything within this drawn area. Now I'm going to left click and go back to my select box, which is my default. I'm also going to cover a couple of hotkeys as well. First of all, if we want to quickly access the circle select tool, but not change it here, you can press the C key, and that's going to allow you to access the circle tool. Then when you're done, you can just right click and it will disappear. Next up, we have these options up here, which are the type of selection we have. So right now we're on the set a new selection mode, which pretty much means if I left click and drag to box like this, then left click and drag to box like this, you can see it's going to replace the selection each time. However, if I change it to extend existing selection, notice now when I left click and drag to box select, both of these are now selected. So this is almost like adding to your selection, and it won't reset it each time. You've also got subtract as well, and as you might expect, when I left click and hold to drag, it's now going to remove that from the selection. These two at the end here I don't really tend to use, but you can play around with them if you would like. Also, there's a few selection hotkeys that are useful to know, and you'll end up using them when you're modeling as well. So the first one, if you want to select everything in your scene, you can press A. And I like to think of it as A for all. If you want to deselect everything, you can just press Alt A. So remember how Alt R and Alt G were resetting rotation and location? You can think of Alt A as resetting selection. So we're going back to the default, which is with nothing selected. So Alt A to deselect everything. Then of course, as you know, when we left click an object, it's going to select them. But what if we want to select multiple at once without using the box select or anything like that? Well, we can hold down the shift key and then we can left click, and you'll now notice that I can now select multiple objects just using the left click. Of course, when you have multiple objects selected, if I press G for example to grab, you'll notice I can move all my objects at the same time. Next up on our toolbar, we have this cursor option, and I actually have a video already on the 3D cursor, and I'm going to add it to the playlist for around episode 6 in this series. But if you want to check it out just now, you're more than welcome to. Next up, we have this move option, and this works just like our grab command. So if I left click one of my objects, you can see these axes will appear, and some people prefer to use this rather than the grab command. So to use this, it's very simple. You just left click one of the arrows and hold, and that allows you to move objects this way. I can right click to undo that. You also notice there's these squares, and this one for example works like the G and then Shift Z command, which means it's only going to move on the X and Y axis. Then, as you might imagine, next one we have is Rotate, which will allow us to rotate our object by left clicking and holding these circular lines. We also have a scale option as well, and this works with these cube looking arrows. I can left click and hold them to scale our object that way. You can also hold down the center to scale the whole thing up like this. Then we have the transform, and this pretty much allows you to transform in every way you like at once. So you see I can scale, and I can rotate, and I can move all with just one tool. I personally prefer using the hotkeys though, as it's a lot quicker. Next up, we have this annotate option. When I left click this, this will bring up a pen, and what this allows me to do is make notes. So I like to use this a lot when I'm doing videos, so I definitely find it a useful tool to have. And I just realized that I made an arrow point to a cube, which is technically a cuboid. Next up, we have Measure. We won't go too in-depth into this because it's a little bit out of the scope of today's tutorial, but essentially what it allows you to do is you can left click and drag with it selected, and you see I can create a measurement in 3D space. Something cool you can do as well is if you left click and drag it and then press one of the axes on your keyboard, so for example Z, you'll notice I can now kind of lock it to up and down, although it tends to be a little bit glitchy. So let's just left click it there, and now when I rotate around my object, you can see this is a line going straight up and down. I can also left click and drag, and then I can hold down X, and if I release, you can see that I've created a straight line across the X axis too. Next up, we have the Add Cube option. This is a pretty cool tool, just allows you to quickly add things in Blender. So I can left click and hold with this, and you can see it's a yellow square is going to appear. I'm just going to release my mouse here, and after your mouse releases, you'll notice I can now drag it up. So I can bring it up, and I can choose roughly how big I want my cube to be, so maybe right here. And once I'm satisfied, I can just left click, and you can see it's created a nice cube for me. If I left click and hold this, you can see we can add a bunch of other what you call primitives in Blender. So I've got a cone, a cylinder, a UV sphere, and an icosphere. Let's try cylinder. So I'll left click and drag, and you can see I can decide the circumference of our cylinder here. Then once I release my mouse, I can just pull it up, and I can decide how tall I want my cylinder to be. I'll left click there, and there we got a nice cylinder. And yeah, that just about covers it. I thought I'd quickly go over the toolbar in Blender and how it can be useful in a few different cases, especially for selection. If you're enjoying this series and want to follow along with the upcoming videos, make sure to check out the playlist where I'll take you from a total beginner in Blender to understanding a lot of 3D modeling fundamentals in the software. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.